All right, so since my connection is fraudulent as a fuck up in this lobby, but it was the only one available. Well, it wasn't the only one available. It was a Japanese lobby. And let me tell you, those are some rude people. Can we talk about anger? Let's talk about anger. There are so many things today that have angered me. Thus, we shall speak regarding anger. Number one, the Japanese people. Not the entire Japanese people, the like three people that were in this lobby. You know what? Not even the three people that are in that lobby. I don't know what the opinion was of the other two. I'm only gonna speak on the one that kicked me, even though all I wanted to do was watch and see the godlike Japanese play, because obviously every single person in Japan is equally godlike at the game, right? Right, yeah, their average totally is not basically equivalent to our average. Not at all. They're definitely all basically a country full of just Tokidos and FABs and who else? Ogawa. I don't actually know if there are any Japanese like considered Unio gods. Like how, you know, in BlazBlue, you have people like Galileo, for instance. Inno would be another one. Dora's pretty damn good, obviously, but I don't think he's really... You know what? He's gotten a lot better, I gotta be honest. Because he's starting to compete with those guys now. But plus, Bang has also improved a lot in Extend, as far as I'm aware. Yo, damn, this Lena is going in. Oh, that's right. J-Rel has always been a pretty quality player. Pretty sure I remember that name from BlazBlue. Is he a Jhin player? I don't know. Anyway, but speaking of Jhin, Fenrich, Yoshiki, that homie's been going in thanks to the new 13 buffs. He's one of the highest ranked people, PSR-wise. I don't know why I'm like, this is, I mean, he was in Grand Finals at Evo. I have no idea why I'm mind blanking in regard to this guy, given that like he was the only Azreal that I found worth watching in CP. So that's a bummer. Boy, this poor Spyhawks. This poor guy. Yeah, given that this was basically the only dude that I found worth watching in CP. But for some reason, I cannot fucking... Why am I just completely and utterly blanked on this dude's name? I cannot, like, I'm gonna spend this entire video just sitting here like, what the fuck is this guy's name? I'll never remember it. Seriously, why can I not remember? This is ridiculous. It's actually because he hasn't really been doing much lately. He switched to new 13 and Hazuma and just immediately, you know what, that's why. I'm blanking him out of my mind, because he switched to new 13 and Hazuma. Fuck that guy. He's not even worth mentioning. Fucking traitor. But anyways, that's what I mean. Like, is there anybody in Unil who is kind of just considered to be, like, just completely and utterly godlike at the game? Because I've never really looked up much Unil footage in general, just because, like, Gordo's straightforward enough that I don't really need to look at how other people play that character. I can figure out how to play that character on my own. I don't need to see how the best players play him, because he's not a difficult character to play. Plain and simple. And then there's no point in looking up Nanase, like trying to see tournament Nanase footage, because Nanase is a console-only character, so you're not gonna find any Japan arcade scene tournament stuff on her. So anyway, that was kind of, this Lena is just fucking everybody up. So the other things that I was angry about. Oh, my iPod died today. So like, I always just have my headphones in when I'm working. Like, obviously, I mean, number one, it helps me focus. Like, I don't want to say I have ADD. Like, everybody has ADD to a degree. It's just a simple fact. Like, there's many people just cannot focus on many things unless it is like ridiculously interesting to them. That is the concept of ADD. Everybody has it. But so anyway, like, I really hate the whole concept of ADD. Like, it's not, whatever. So it helps. It just helps me kind of like stay in a groove, I guess. And then on top of that, it also prevents people from talking to me. I don't like it when people talk to me because, like, these are people that just, I'm not going to have any kind of deep conversation with them. I can't provide them with anything. Like, damn, there are a lot of Hildas in this lobby. Every single person that would attempt to talk to me is utterly useless to me. I know that's an asshole thing to say. It's entirely possible that, like, I have missed 17 soulmates because they were gonna walk up and, like, mac on me, and then they were like, oh, he's wearing headphones, I won't bother him, because, you know, my soulmate would have to be a very polite and considerate person. Anyway, point being, my iPod died, I couldn't listen to shit, and it was, now granted, it didn't help that it was a Walmart, so already you're working in a negative atmosphere. Walmart's not a good place to be. I never go there, I never shop there, but sometimes I have to work there. It sucks. I don't wanna, but I don't got a choice in the matter. And you know what? Just to be perfectly honest, it's kind of one of the best places to work, because you get hella hours, because they're hella busy. It sucks. I don't like being there, but again, I make money. I gotta make my paper. What you gotta do? You do what you gotta do. So anyway, like I said, my iPod died. People started talking to me. This one mother... Now, keep in mind, this is a Walmart that is 45, 50-mile drive away from my home. I am never in this section of the world outside of when I am working at this specific store. Sometimes I work in other stores around that district, like it would be a complete waste to only drive out and, like, ever work one store in that place. But I am never there, like, on my off days. I don't go there. The only time I am ever there is when I was working. So this dude walks up to me in the aisle, and for, like, 5 straight minutes is trying to convince me beyond a shadow of a doubt that he has met me before, he knows me, and he is absolutely positive, because he is a teacher at a shooting range, that he at one point taught me how to shoot a gun. I'm gonna tell you the exact same shit I told him, which should have made him go away. I have never fired a gun in my life. I'm not interested in them. I don't care for them. I have never felt that to be a necessary aspect of character for me. Like, I'm not trying to begrudge people that do, you know, enjoy using guns, enjoy going to the shooting range. I'm perfectly accepted. That's a hobby. Do you. Enjoy your hobbies. But when I tell you, motherfucker, I have never shot a gun in my life. Please leave me alone and let me work. I got shit to do today. That should have been it. That should have been it. But he's like, no, I'm pretty sure I've taught you before to shoot. No. No, you have not. You don't know me. I don't know you. You're like 3 times my age. The only way I would know you is if you were like an uncle or a grandfather. And you are neither. Fuck off. So anyway, finally, he went away. Like, I just kind of, it's kind of, you know, to that point where sometimes you just gotta be an asshole to somebody. And, like, I'm never directly an asshole. Like, I try to be polite whenever I speak. But if I stop speaking, that's my hint. Before I start saying, like, yo, dude, I got shit to, like, I will actually say, like, bro, I gotta work. Nice talking to you, but you gotta go. You in my way. I got shit to do. Please leave me alone. Like, eventually it might get to that point, but I'll still be fairly polite, because obviously, you know, when you're working, you're representing your company, and the last thing you want to hear from a manager is, yo, why did you sock this dude in the face and tell him to fuck off? Not gonna go well. So, anyway, finally I just kind of started ignoring this dude, and he just kind of tapered away and left, and so anyway, that finally ended. But what happens next? I'm sitting there, I'm chilling, I'm getting my work on. This motherfucker walks up and he's like, hey, I used to have a buddy. Used to work for the company that you work for. Pretty sure they fucked him over. They bought him out so they could give his job to some punk who doesn't do it as well, but they can pay less. And I'm just sitting there like, bro, like, why? What does this have to do with me? Why are you relaying this to me? And finally, if the company bought him out, he had to agree to it. That's not fucking anybody over. He took money and left.
What the fuck?
And so anyway, but obviously I can't say that. That's what's in my mind. I'm like, oh, yeah, so fucking, you know, I don't have any problems with this company. Like, I mean, obviously everybody has problems with who they work for. It's a simple fact of life. But nobody worthwhile is going to sit there with some random motherfucker that just walks up to you on the street. Oh, that was godlike. And is going to just, you know, actually pop off on you. Nobody's gonna do that. So anyway, so I just say like, oh, hey, that's a bummer. I've never had that experience myself. So that sucks. What the fuck else am I gonna say? And then he pops off and he's like, you know what? It probably doesn't even matter. Cause it's probably better to be on that Obama welfare than to have a job these days. Oh my God, Walmart. Please. The worst part too is that, like, because this is not a big town. This isn't one of those towns where it's like only, you know, like the grungy, disgusting scum of the earth. No, I don't want to say scum of the earth, because, you know, some of these people are very nice, but they just don't have anywhere else to go. Like, Walmart's the cheapest option you're gonna get. Why would you not go there if you are, you know, if you're on a budget, basically? Why would you not shop there? But let's just say there's a stereotypical Walmart patronage for a reason. But however, like I said, this is not, you know, a big town where you have a bunch of other, you know, options. Walmart's basically it. Like, they don't have any other electronic stores. They don't really have any dedicated clothing stores, aside from like small little, you know, mom and pop kind of a deal. So if you're looking for something, in general, Walmart's kind of your only option up here. So, you know, I can't say, you know, everybody that comes in here is going to be the kind of person that's going to be, you know, like that 500-pound motherfucker that's driving around on those electric carts and, you know, taking up aisles and threatening to just kill anybody, like, with an earth-shattering earthquake if they happen to tip over, that kind of shit. It's not, obviously, there are people like that there, but it's not the entire clientele. That being, you know, so you get everybody from every walks of life. I have to admit, this particular Walmart has some of the most attractive females I have ever seen in a Walmart ever, which can sometimes make my job a little bit happy, per se. But still, it's just, you know, when you walk in there, you're gonna get people like that. People who think they understand politics, that Obama is just ruining the country, and it has absolutely nothing to do with the fact that we probably have the worst Congress in the history of the United States, basically cock-blocking everything he wants to do. Not to say Obama is faultless, obviously, and I don't want to get into a huge political argument here, because I'm supposed to be talking about O'Neill and identifying Hilda stuff so I can actually fight this fucking character, but we're talking about what I get angry at. And it was this motherfucker, thinking he knows what he's talking about, like it's better to be on welfare than to have a job. Nobody thinks that. Now, don't get me wrong. There are people that abuse the shit out of welfare. But I guarantee you, the majority of people that are on welfare are good people in a bad spot that need that help. But if they had the choice between a steady job with a solid income or welfare, they pick the fucking steady job. Why do you have to be such an asshole to people? God! So anyway, that's number two thing that makes me mad. Number three thing that makes me mad. It's hot as fuck up in this bitch. It's finally become summer. So, because it has become summer, like I said, it's gotten hot. So I decided after work today, I'ma head over to a Jamba Juice. I'ma get my smoothie on. I haven't gone there in ages because, like, I've just been making my own smoothies. Like, fuck Jamba Juice. But it's kind of, you know, it's to that point where, like, it's not that hot. Like, I think the high was, like, 92 degrees today, which is not that hot. Yes, it's hot, but it's California. It's not California hot. However, it's that, you know, the transitional period. You know, like, I'm used to low 80s, high 70s at this point in time, and all of a sudden, the 90-plus degree day pops off, and it feels like you're in the Sahara Desert or some shit. It does not feel good. So anyway, I decided to go to Jamba Juice. You know, like, I don't have any energy to make my own shit. Just let me go somewhere, and they're gonna make my shit for me. So I go there. and I see they have a cooler, freshly squeezed juice, in little 12-ounce bottles. And I'm thinking, you know what? I could go for some lemonade. I'ma grab this shit. It's probably gonna be over expensive. It's gonna be like $2 for this fucking 12-ounce bottle. But fuck it. Fall out. I got some overtime today. I got some cash. You know what I'm saying? So, I bought that shit. I had to ring it up. And then my total came to $11.03. And I'm like, wait, what the? $11.03? Did you guys raise your prices? And then I look up. No. Price of that smoothie is about $5.50. Well, then what the fuck? So I look over. Oh, there's the price for this juice. $4.79 for a 12-ounce thing of juice. Are you fucking crazy? I could have, if I had known that, I would have gone to a grocery store and bought the goddamn ingredients myself. I wouldn't have even gotten a juicer. I would have just squeezed that shit in my bare hands and gotten like 5 gallons of juice for that price if I just bought the shit myself. Assholes! Could not believe that. Now, granted, I should have just been like, can you take that off? That's a fucking ridiculous price. Like, honestly, I kind of, you know, like, thinking back, I honestly think, like, the person was kind of staring at me like, wait, somebody's actually buying this shit? Yes! Poor suckers who don't fucking think to look at a price and just assume, it's gonna be like $2 at the most. And it ends up being more than double that. Son of a bitch! So mad! So anyway, is there anything else that has made me mad today? I got a leg cramp, specifically in my calf muscle. That's the fucking worst. Anything else? There's gotta be something else. I get angry at everything. Oh! Let's talk about Steam. The Steam Summer Flash Sale is on right now. Now, I'm not mad at that. Shout outs to discounts. You gotta love discounts. Who doesn't love paying less for things that you want? Everybody likes discounts. They're a wonderful, beautiful thing. That said, this game shit they got going right now, click until your finger gets tired? How fun. How exciting. It's not supposed to be, like, it's just, it's a flash game. Like, what do you expect? It's Half-Life 3? How many people actually, I still have not played Half-Life 1 or 2. I think those are on sale right now, actually. But so anyway, let's watch some Hilda. Let's watch some Silica Saber. Let's get some understanding of this character, and that hurt. Got that spine like right up. Maybe she enjoys it. I don't care enough. I'm not gonna judge. What do you want to kick it? Probably everybody in this fucking game kinky. It's an anime game written by anime people. I'm still like, I still regret having played Nanase story mode. Woo! That was some dumb shit. Oh, got bodied! I'm surprised Jay Rail has not returned to the lobby by now. Reiko down! That's the name of the game that. Oh, man. If y'all have never heard of Breakdown. Woo! Is that. Let me. I'm gonna go check PC. I'm gonna go check Steam and see if that shit is on PC. You know what From Software needs to do? From Software needs to. No, Breakdown is not here. There's a State of Decay DLC called Breakdown. Anyway, Breakdown is this game that. It was honestly. I mean, the first half of it kind of sucked. And then the second half of it, you get superpowers and everything's fucking awesome. Like, it was so much fun once that part opened up. It was an amazing game. It was 100% first person. So, like, imagine Mirror's Edge if the cutscenes were also in first person mode. You never leave first person mode. It's actually quite. I love that game. It was kind of a technical mess. Like, there were parts of it which just were like, this is some bad coding. But overall, like, man, that was a fantastic game. And I don't know why it just occurred to me. Like, I mean, obviously, I've played this game for so long. You see Breakdown plenty of times, but how that was just like, oh, I love that game. Similarly, anyway, as I was going to mention, FromSoftware needs to put the Otogi games on Steam. I'm just saying, like, everybody, all of you, every single person that watches this, I am going to chain email you as well to ensure that this gets done, because I have all of your email addresses. Every single one of you has to tell From Software in at least 3 different places, Twitter, forums, emails, regular mail, go ahead and send them, like, packages of stuff. I don't know, like, go ahead and send them that glitter shit, or, like, mail somebody a cardboard dick, you know, whatever the kids are doing these days. Put Otogi on Steam, and also Otogi 2, because Otogi 2 was a better game than Otogi 1. That being said, if you do not do this as well as send this on to 5 of your friends, you will never find love. I'm just saying. That's a guarantee. I guarantee it. I still don't know where that's from. I am also not saying it correctly. Because the dude is like hella old, and he has one of those like raspy voices that you can only get when you grow old as fuck. So, yeah. But still, like I'm telling you. Let him know. And if you haven't played Otogi, you should play it. I was really sad because I don't... The Xbox 360's backwards compatibility is kind of weird. They basically started out with like a certain set of games, and they would just update, you know, what games were backwards compatible for a while. But for some reason, Otogi never made that list, which makes me incredibly sad. But I didn't know that, you know, I wasn't sure. I'm not gonna look up the fucking list. Who got time for that? So I just popped the Otogi 2 disc into my Xbox 360, and it recognized it. It said, you know, like, play Otogi 2. So I was like, oh, I'm gonna do a playthrough of this. I don't care if nobody watches it. I'm gonna have fun, and this is gonna be fun as hell. And then I clicked on it, and it was like, this game is not supported by backwards compatibility. Maybe an update is available. Please check. You know, whatever the fuck. There's no update available. Of course there's not, you goddamn cock teases. Well, anyway, that was a massive disappointment. So can she actually not go? I feel like I've seen her confirm off of that, but maybe it was with a chain shift. Maybe it requires a chain shift. Hilda's, man, they're going in. Y'all stop talking about other things for at least a little bit, because I'm actually playing Pokemon right now, as well as, you know, watching, because I don't really need to pay terribly close attention to what's going on. Grinding. I actually, first time ever, I'm actually doing EV training. Never done it before. Never cared. I don't even know why I'm doing it now, to be perfectly honest, other than shits and giggles. There's really no other reason other than shits and giggles. But, the shits and giggles are real. And so, the very first Pokemon I ever did, it was actually just to see, so I could see a comparison, so I could look at, like, you know, okay, what's the difference here? How significant does proper EV training, create a disparity between, you know, like, just an average, you know, whatever, I was just going through the game and, you know, blowing shit up, versus, you know, making an effort to train them the specific stats that I wanted them to. And so the one that I tried was Ninetales, and, the Ninetales that I properly EV trained had like the same special attack at level something like 55 or something like that is the one that I just, you know, did whatever with at level 70. That was pretty crazy. But yeah, so now I'm also doing it with Cyndaquil and Glaceon. I don't know why. Like, I already EV trained a Ninetales. Why am I doing another fire Pokemon? I don't fucking know, but I am. Shut up. Who asked you? Why are you questioning me? Hilda's fucking laughing at me. That's kind of a bitch move. Man, look at that asshole Dark Sonic X Shadow. He's actually playing people with a zero bar connection. Who would do that? Only the true heroes among men recognize that you should not ever put somebody through Damn. There is no character variety in this lobby. It's Lena and it's Hilda. Oh, and there's one fucking Carmine. Carmine doesn't count because he's not a rare dude to begin with. You gotta chill with that sound effect. That's a weird ass sound effect. See, that's what you get. You playing zero bars, you drop your shit. Does Hilda have any? I'm analyzing right now. I'm in analyzation mode. How do you tell which direction that shit's supposed to come out? Can you? I need to pay attention to that to see if there's any kind of nuance that will let me know whether or not that shit's gonna come out to the right or come out to the left. Maybe something with Hilda? Yeah, I can't see any difference. I have no idea what, like, for all I know, it could be, like, the Hilda player holds a direction as it's, you know, coming out. So, like, the direction they're holding as it activates is the direction that it goes in. So, like, if I see a Hilda down backing or some shit, then I should let it run. And then I know it's going to the left. Or if I see a Hilda, well, that really won't even work because a Hilda can still crouch and hold down forward. And it would look obviously exactly the same. Oh, interesting. It looks like Lena has a role. That's cool. Maybe I should play her. Anybody with anything that can get through the zoning and whiff punish it. Because I feel like that's the big thing. See right there. Yeah, that's the big thing with Hilda. She has these amazing moves, amazing hitboxes. Excuse me, amazing hitboxes. But on whiff, they're all like it. Just, your life sucks if you whiff this move, basically. Yo, that 180 degree GP? Gotta love that kind of design. I don't. That's a lie. I'm a lie. I'm perfectly good. Seriously, fuck anybody that has a 180 degree DP. Including. Well, actually, it doesn't really include. Because his, Gordo. Because Gordo, this isn't actually a DP. It's just very, very fucking fast. I mean, granted, his metered version is obviously the same kind of hitbox. Actually, it's a larger hitbox. You know, it's the same exact kind of thing. It's just, it's only invincible if you use meter versus characters like Lena, who do have, you know what, actually come to think of it, I have no idea if it would make sense, if Nanase's DP was 360 degrees, given that she creates a whirlwind around herself, but the hitbox of the move is, it's basically the hitbox of the move is so, there's so little horizontal range to it to begin with, that I think it would be pretty damn hard to actually get it to hit on the opposite side of her. Like, above her, absolutely. Right next to her, absolutely. Would be difficult as hell to make it happen on, intentionally. Because anybody with a cross-up move, I think, would kind of just be able to jump out of range. Are they intentionally mashing each other? If they are, that's absolutely adorable. Oh, I forgot Lena had that little dragon-looking motherfucker. I'm gonna call him Mushu. He's Mushu from now on. I don't give a shit what his actual name is. He's Mushu. Mushu wish he could fly. That's another thing I need to do. The same exact thing she did. I feel like that's a really important component of this game. In general, if you want to, like, properly apply pressure, is being able to do 5A canceling. And like I said, I mentioned it before, it's a very important thing for Nanase, because almost all of Nanase's normals, almost all of Nanase's moves in general are unsafe on block. However, 3C into 5A is neutral. I just wish shit was jump cancelable. That's the one thing. If there's one thing I could ask, I would ask for, just one, is one jump cancelable normal on block. Just because I would absolutely love to be capable of doing, like, whatever on block into a TK projectile. Like, I legitimately feel like, ooh, that lag. I legitimately feel like that would be really amazing. And I would absolutely love it. I must still be laggy. I can't see it. Obviously. Spectation mode is not, as far as I'm aware, you're not like actually watching them play, you're watching like a very slightly delayed replay basically. So like the game's just recreating the match for you. Just a little bit later. Sorry about that sound. I accidentally caved in my Mandarin. Oh, it is Mandarin orange. You just can't actually, from the angle that I was looking at it, the orange is light enough that I can't actually see it. I can only see the Mandarin. God, I wish I could see the Mandarin. Not that shitty Iron Man 3 Mandarin, but the real one. I guess that's kind of technically an Iron Man 3 spoiler, but I don't really consider that bad because Iron Man 3 sucked. I like the whole aspect of, like, pretty much PTSD Tony, but that was about it. That was about the only thing that I liked. Because, I mean, you know, you don't want to see this just absolutely infallible dude that has no problems and just blows everything up. I mean, well, you know, that's not a bad thing either. But you don't want to see three straight movies of it. Or more, since obviously he's a fairly central component of the Avengers. That's Carmine! The only thing that always bugged me. A grid break on a yellow? Damn, Carmine just went fucking... Carmine just went fucking nuts! Carmine is... Wait, I fucked up. I'm gonna shut up now. I was gonna say Carmine is just Carmine, but then I reversed it. And now I'm ashamed. But how, like, you watch 2GB combo play? And he's legitimately just like in somebody's face and he does empty assault like four times in a row and then goes into a low. And I'm just sitting there like, man, come on. At least mash a little bit. Don't let him do it that many times to you. That's embarrassing. Yo, what the hell is this dude's P? Like, I just realized. I thought, like, for some reason, because I'd never looked at it all that closely, I thought it had said, like, Bryce the God or something. Which would actually make sense, but no, that is some... whatever the fuck. I don't know.
First floor, divide.
This guy does jump back assault one more goddamn time! Like, yo, real talk. And just sit there and anti it. I think they were mashing it, actually. Ooh, I've never seen that before. That was interesting. Sucks I got hit by it. See, just tried to jump back assault again. Blown the fuck up for it. Okay, so they were dashing forward right there, and that shit went forward. I think that's it. That would make sense, since there's no way to actually identify. Like, at least not that I can tell. There's no way to identify by just sight. Like, there's no unique aspects to that shit. Look at that, both of them using their full screen shit, just showing off. They're laughing at my face right now. They are laughing in my face. Intentionally. They know what they're doing. Dicks. I got my pathetic little DP animation. Shit makes me so sad. Like, these are the characters that need a full screen tracking super like that. So shots to this dude's defense though? Can we talk about that? I swear to God, stop doing jump back assault. Fuck's sake. Oh my God, he did a jump forward assault! Thank you for killing them. Thank you for killing them off of a jump back assault. That, my friends, is proper justice done in the world. Also, Hilda laughs too much. She's gonna wear out her vocal cords. She's never gonna be a proper opera singer if she keeps laughing like that. Just won't happen. Oh my God! Oh, never mind. Ignore me. I got excited because I thought my Quilava was gonna evolve into Typhlosion. Typhlosion's one of my favorite. All my favorite dudes in general are fire type. Like, my favorite Pokemon in the world. I kind of make it a point whenever I play a new game to always use Pokemon that I've never used before. So I never, I don't just always, you know, play the game and have the same exact party. I learn new Pokemon. I try to figure out, you know, some unique aspects to them, or I try to, you know, I try to pick them based on obviously a mixture of efficiency, aesthetics, and just, you know, obviously you want a diversity of types. And so I always, like I said, I always try to choose different ones if they're available. That being said, no matter what, I will always, if a Growlithe is available, that dude is my fire type. Like, there is no, I will never use a different fire type. Because he's always been, ever since I was a kid, like, I'm a dog dude. I absolutely love dogs. I've never had any other pets besides dogs. Like, I absolutely adore dogs. So obviously, Growlithe is gonna be my home. Like, Pokemon was a big part of my childhood. Simple fact, you know, like, there were basically like four main games that I played the shit out of as a kid. Mega Man Battle Network, Golden Sun, Dragon Warrior 3, and Pokemon. Like, those were my big ones. I played those non-stop, and so, and obviously Pokemon, as you know, like, most of the Mega Man Battle Network and Golden Sun weren't around the Game Boy Advance days, so I was pretty far on. But, you know, like, Pokemon was one of the first video games I ever played. Pokemon Red. I bought the first game I ever bought with my own money was Pokemon Red. I actually bought that shit before I ever had a Game Boy, just so I could have it for when I finally saved up enough money to buy my own Game Boy. And I did that shit. Oh, you better believe I did that shit. That's how I learned how to save money. Yeah, so anyway, like I said, that was a huge part of my childhood. I played a lot of various playthroughs of that game. I really enjoyed it. So, you know, and my favorite dude is Growlithe. So no matter what, if Growlithe is in the game and available, I will use them. Unless it's, you can't get him until, like, the end of the game. Because, like, in this one, in I'm playing Omega Ruby right now. If you You can only get him after you beat the Elite Four. So at that point, it's kind of just like, ah, well, I've basically done everything. Like, what's the point now? It's kind of late for that. But I think it was in Black and White 2, you could get him almost at the very beginning of the game. And I was like, yay! And I used him. But other than that, that's the one exception to the rule. Other than that, I always try to use different dudes. So in this one, I use, like I said, the aforementioned Ninetales. I'm using Tropius. Electrode, I've never used him before. Who are my other ones? Hariyama, is that his name? The big-ass fighting type. He's like a sumo wrestler kind of dude. I'm using him. And I'm trying to remember who else because... Oh, I used Latias for quite a while. I think that's it, actually, because I had two spaces taken up by Whale Lord and the Noon for my HM Digimon. Anyway, enough talk about that. Let's talk about more. Just this constant barrage of Lina and Hilda. Overhead. Can you combo off that? Is that an overhead, too, when it cycles like that? The fuck did she get hit by? I actually don't know. I didn't actually see her get hit by anything. Huh. That's interesting. Alright, well anyway, this will be the last match because... Oh good, the last match will be a Hildimir match. That's appropriate. This is my problem when I'm spectating. I barely pay attention. Like, even though I know I should be paying attention so I can learn as much as possible about this character and about other characters that I have not really had the... that I haven't been able to gain, like, a large amount of matchup experience against. I mean, it really doesn't matter what you can analyze in general if you can't also test how to react to certain situations. So I can see, you know, like, oh, okay, this is how this move works in general, but, you know, what's my answer to it? I can't know that unless I'm actually trying to find that answer. So it's only, you know, it's only doing half of the work. Plus, it doesn't help that, you know, when it's not characters you're actually interested in. You know, like, I'm interested in nice, very, very slick Veil off. That was very useful. Definitely close enough to have an impact. Maybe they wanted to just, like, Veil off into the special move, but that obviously has a huge amount of recovery, and you're fighting the character who can just fill the screen with shit. So that's not gonna go well. Bam. Not good blocking, never mind, I lied. I thought that was good blocking, but they were just blocking. They were gonna block high until the end of days. But their day ended early. Ha ha!